Birth looks different for everyone.
Oh, car baby.
There is no one right way to meet your baby. Is a C-section safer than a vaginal birth? How many can you have? And why might you need one? This is Your Body On, Getting a C-Section. A C-section, or cesarean section, is the delivery of a baby through an incision in the mother's abdomen. Its practice dates back thousands of years, initially as a last-ditch effort to save the child of a dying or dead mother. The pain was excruciating, but often short-lived. Until the 19th century, women who had C-sections had about a 90% chance of dying. But you can relax. Today, the risk is only 0.002% in the U.S.
So soft.
C-sections are no longer the thing of horror movies, but for an unsuspecting mother,
we're gonna do a C-section right away.
It can still feel like it. Planned or unplanned? About 30% of U.S. babies are born through C-sections.
I love you.
Typically, they are performed if a vaginal delivery would put the baby or mother at risk.
Safe now.
A cesarean section is the safest method for multiples. This helps to avoid entangled babies and placentas during delivery.
I did it.
It is necessary for mothers with HIV or active herpes sores in the vagina to avoid transmission to the baby. The fetus should be head down. If it is stuck in a feet-first or bottom-first position, a C-section is necessary. Or if the placenta detaches prematurely or blocks the cervix, a vaginal birth might be too dangerous. These complications are usually detected early in the pregnancy, allowing the procedure to be planned in advance. But birth is unpredictable.
Can't do it, I can't do it.
Sometimes the need for a C-section isn't clear until a woman is in labor. An emergency cesarean is required if the fetus is too large to push through the birth canal, has a severe drop in heart rate, or gets tangled in its umbilical cord.
Let's prep her fast.
Stay calm, you're in good hands. The procedure. From scalpel to suture, the entire surgery usually takes only 45 minutes. A surgeon will shave any hair around the incision site and wipe the area with an antiseptic solution to prevent infections. A catheter will drain your urine, and an intravenous line will supply fluids and drugs. Most C-sections are done under regional anesthesia, which numbs only the lower part of your body. This allows you to stay awake during the surgery.
I'm just so excited.
The anesthesia's effects will begin about 20 to 30 minutes after injection. The anesthesiologist will monitor your heart rate, breathing, and blood oxygen, while your partner will offer emotional support, if they can.
Dad passed out.
The surgeon will make an incision above your pubic bone using a scalpel or electrocautery machine, which can seal off bleeding more effectively. Then, they separate the muscles, cut through your uterus, open the amniotic sac, and remove the baby. She's perfect. The surgeon will cut off the umbilical cord, remove the placenta, and inspect your uterus for any tears. You'll be stitched up, wrapped in bandages, and wheeled off to the recovery section. This procedure was a success.
I can't believe the parents.
But not all moms are so lucky. Complications. In the U.S., mothers are 500 times more likely to die from C-sections than vaginal births. The leading cause of death is hemorrhaging, which might occur if the doctor accidentally cuts into an artery. Steady. If a hemorrhage occurs, you may require an emergency cesarean hysterectomy, which is the total removal of the uterus. You would be infertile for the rest of your life. After delivery, you'll have some risk of infection or damage at the incision site, but the biggest concern is blood clots. Your blood clumps more easily during pregnancy to prepare for labor and delivery, and even more so during surgery to prevent blood loss. If a clot travels to your lungs, it can cause life-threatening blockages. If you plan to have more children, you might have to face these risks twice over. A vaginal birth after C-section, or VBAC, is possible for some women, but not all. It is out of the question if you have vertical scars, as they are most likely to rupture during contractions. Every woman who attempts a VBAC faces a 1% chance that her uterus could rupture. About 60 to 80% of women who try having a VBAC have successful vaginal births. But repeat C-sections could still be dangerous. They increase the risk of a displaced placenta, which could cause excessive bleeding during delivery. The thick bands of scar tissue from the first surgery will make incisions more challenging and increase your odds of surgical injury or excess bleeding. But that's a future problem. For now, focus on healing. Recovery. You will remain in the recovery room for at least 2 hours following delivery. You may be with your baby and even begin breastfeeding.
She latched.
This is amazing.
As the anesthesia wears off, you'll begin to feel pain. Don't worry, there will be painkillers. Your intestinal tract will start working again, so you might feel a little gassy. That makes two of you. After a couple of days, you'll regain some independent movement and go home. Try to take it easy. In addition to feeling sore, you'll be dealing with a lot of the same symptoms as a vaginal birth. These include fatigue, cramping, vaginal bleeding, and raging hormones. Expect your scar to be sore for at least a few weeks, so don't do any heavy exercise or lifting. You can cuddle and nurse your newborn, but place the baby on a pillow over your incision to protect it. Make sure to keep the wound clean. Call your doctor immediately if you experience heavy vaginal bleeding, a fever, increased pain and bleeding from the incision, or trouble breathing. You might have an infection. Remember to be kind to yourself, and when you can, relax. In weeks, you'll be on your way to full steam mommy mode. Just be happy it's only one baby. Imagine raising 8 kiddos. What does an octuplet pregnancy look like?
It's horrible.
We'll find out on another episode of Your Body On.